Hello friends, welcome back to another video. So in today's video I'm going to explain how we can prep the practice hand for our nail extension. So when we try to learn extensions or even nail art, we may require a practice hand to, you know, just play around and learn things. So I have a plastic practice hand. I'm going to show you how I prep the plastic hand for my practices. So before we start, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified about all my new videos. So let's begin with the video. So there are different types of practice hands available in the market. Some of them are made out of plastic, some of them are made out of silicon. The silicon one is like more realistic. Unfortunately, I couldn't find the silicon one in India, so I had to compromise with the plastic one. So I got this one from one of the Insta sellers that I purchased products from. So this is how it looks. It looks like a normal lady finger. So it's not giant actually. So it's like a normal female hand. So that is one thing I liked about it. I won't say it's very flexible, but yeah, see, we can still work with it. So I'm just going to show you how I prep this plastic hand. We cannot really do anything when it's like this. We have to actually prep it and then we can actually do our practice. That's what I'm going to show you in this video. Before I even prep the hands, I just wanted to see how flexible it was. So as you can see, it does bend, but it's not like very flexible, very comfortable, but I think it's fine. It's just 450 rupees or something, so I'm not really mad, but yeah, it could have been a little more better. But now let's just see how we can prep it. So our very first step is to file off the shine from the nail area of the practice hand. For that I am using Model 1's 100-180 grit, and I will be using the softer side, which is the 180 grit side, and I am just going to gently buff off that shine from the surface. The reason being, I cannot really apply the product directly onto this nail area because we need to apply or use a nail tip or plastic tip, and then we can start the application process of acrylic or gel or whatever you wanted to do. You always start with a tip. So now I gently file off that shine from all the five fingers, and then I will show you how I use the tips. I have these ballerina nail tips from one of the Insta sellers. Our next step is to figure out which number goes into which finger. So you have to segregate it and you have to keep it aside. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to match the size and then I'm going to figure out which one fits well on the practice hand. Once you figure out the right size of the nail tip, you can use a marker and you can write down that number on the back side of the practice hand. So this way you don't have to, you know, really match the tips every time you take out the practice hand for your practice. So this will save you some time. So that is the next step I have to do. After segregating all the right numbers, I'm going to use this buffer file to file off the shine from the tips. So this is another important step when you do the practice. Just like we filed off the shine from the practice hand, you have to also file off the shine from the nail tips. So this way, what happens if you apply acrylic or gel or anything and you cure it, and when you file and shape, you have to put pressure, right, when you file it. So if it's shiny, then you may end up, you know, removing the product from the nail tip. So this way we can ensure that the product stick to the nail tip and you can, you know, easily file off your excess product, and basically you can do the filing and shaping without any problem. Now our next step is to stick the tips onto the practice hand, right? So for that I have two options. One is using this tack it, that's what the name is. So it's kind of an adhesive. You can stick anything using this particular product. So there are these small bar like things, so you can just gently break one piece and you can use it to stick anything basically. So that's what we are going to try first. So I just broke one piece from that tack it, and then I'm going to just remove it half, and then I'm going to stick the tip onto my practice hand. So just watch it carefully. If you're going to just apply gel polish, or if you just wanted to do some nail art practice or something, then I recommend you to just use this one. So this is easy to remove also. All you have to do is just pull it off and it will come off. So I just place that tacky thing onto the practice hand, and after that I'm going to pick one of the tips and I'm going to push it hard, and that way it sticks to the practice hand. So just watch it carefully. So in this one, if you're just doing gentle practice, then it won't move at all. But if you're just going to do like rough filing or anything, then it won't stick. So basically this one can be used to do some nail art practice, or if you just wanted to practice some hand painting or something, then you can obviously use this option. Now I'm going to show you the second option, which is my preferred method. So for this, I have clear acrylic, I have the extension brush, and I have the dipping dish, and I also have the monomer. So I'm not using the expensive products here, I'm using the cheaper ones. So I'm dipping my brush into the monomer, and after that I'm going to pick up a clear bead. So the bead size can be like between small and medium, or you can take a medium size bead and you can place it on top of the nail area of your practice hand. And after you place the bead onto the practice hand, immediately you pick up the plastic tip and you place it on top of the acrylic bead that you just placed, and then gently press it. And the acrylic, as you know, it air dries, and it will immediately like within 30 seconds or something, the acrylic will dry and your tip will stuck to your practice hand. And once this is done, you can start with your practice, whether it's acrylic or gel extension practice or any kind of practice that you wanted to do, you can start practicing. So this way your tip will not move at all. So that's why this is my preferred method. I prefer this because I wanted to file and shape my nails. So I use this method to actually do my practice. So this is a fully done practice hand. Now all I have to do is clip the tips and start practice. So after clipping the tips, this is how it looks. You can now apply the foam and start practicing your acrylic extension. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you like it, don't forget to like, share, comment, all those good things. And also don't forget to subscribe and enable the notification. I'll see you soon on my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.